Google Ads Editor is a powerful tool to bulk manage your Google Ads accounts. Many users will be working on multiple accounts, each potentially containing hundreds of thousands or even millions of items. So how can you work on all that efficiently? By the time we are done with this video, you will be able to create searches to filter your view to find exactly what you want quickly. Combine searches in powerful ways with multiple chips and functions. Create a custom rule that converts searches into a formidable QA tool. Ready to dive in? Let's explore the Google Ads Editor's advanced search tool and custom rules. Advanced search. Advanced search allows you to find exactly what you are looking for to streamline and improve your workflows. To start things off, open your account in a window and click into the advanced search bar to start filtering the current view. When you focus into the advanced search bar, you will see a menu overview of the available search options to begin, all searchable fields for the current type, recent searches, saved searches, and more. You can select from the menu or simply begin typing. As you type, the menu shows you all available searches that match what you have typed so far. In either case, selecting a field from the menu moves you to the next step. Select a comparison and enter a value to use in that comparison. What values are valid depends on the type of field you are searching on. Click Apply or hit Enter and you have completed a search chip. You can add as many search chips as you like to filter down to exactly what you are looking for. An item must pass all active filters to be displayed. Recent searches. Recent searches will appear at the top of the initial menu so that it is easier to rerun popular searches. Search chips. Blue chips are active and are filtering the current view. Gray chips are valid searches but not active for the current type. Therefore, they don't affect which entities you see on that tab. Red chips indicate an invalid search and are not active on any type. If you hover over a red chip, a tooltip will give you insight into what is wrong. Type nav entity counts. The active filter runs on every entity type. The type nav indicates how many of each type have passed the filter. Each view will be filtered by the search chips that are active for that type. If all chips are inactive for a given type, no filtering will be done. Functional searches. You can make some powerful searches using a combination of chips, but to take it to the next level, you can use the functions feature. With functions, you can combine filters in new ways to find highly specific items in your Google Ads account. By default, all search chips are ANDed. That is, an entity must pass all criteria to be shown. If desired, you can find items that pass any of the filters by using the OR function. Container searches. The Search Within editor allows you to filter on not only the type you are looking at, but also aspects of its parent. To do this, use the container functions. Child searches. Likewise, you can add filters on items within campaigns, ad groups, and asset groups using the exists and count functions, among others. Custom rules. You can save a search to use later, either in the advanced search bar or to create a custom rule. Custom rules are user-defined validations that use the robust advanced search backend to allow you to create your own QA environment. Custom rules run in the background to make sure any change you make conforms to your policy. Violations show in the main grid, the type nav, the container view, and the edit pane, just like built-in errors and warnings. To view and manage your custom rules, select Advanced Tools in the type nav and then select the Custom Rules tab. Create a new rule. Click on Add a New Custom Rule and then give the rule a name. This is used to identify the rule and filter on future violations. Add a message that will be displayed in the error bar when an item violates this rule. Select which types this rule should be applied to. Only these types will be checked against this rule. Next, define the violation criteria. This is the same as the advanced search discussed earlier in the video and can follow the same procedure. Create a new search or load in a saved one. Remember, items that pass this criteria are considered in violation of the rule and will be marked with a splat. Finally, select the severity of the rule. The default setting provides a warning that you will see in the interface. The other option is to set it as an error. This prevents the posting of any item in violation of that custom rule. Anytime you add a new rule or edit an existing one, you must apply the changes before they go into effect. Click on Apply Rule Changes on the bar at the top of the window to run the new rules. Once applied, the rule will check any relevant change and apply a violation when appropriate. Show violations. Any active rule will show the number of violations in the account. You can filter on items that violate this rule by clicking the Show Violations link in the Edit panel, or by clicking the Show Violation button in the error bar. This will add a search chip that filters to only those items that violate the rule. This search chip will only be active on the types the rule applies to. Google Ads Editor provides a powerful search tool to streamline your Google Ads management. You can also leverage that to create rules that enhance your QA environment. For more information, visit the Google Ads Help Center.